So all of you know, dear students, and we are discussing the concept of congruency, one of the vital chapter of geometry. Okay, in the previous class we already discussed about the definition of the congruency and the usefulness of congruency. Okay, and in the previous class we already discussed about the concept of congruency. Yes or no? Okay, so what is congruency? Congruency is the branch of geometry, the vital part of mathematics, and it's important part of geometry, which deals with the study of the object having the same sides. Okay, it is discussed in the previous class. In this class I am going to discuss about the congruent of triangles. So what is congruent of triangles? Understand? So for this we can see here, two triangles are said to be congruent when the two triangles are said to be congruent. Look at here. And I told, according to the definition of congruent, two objects are congruent if they are completely superimposed. Are you seeing here the two triangular object here only? They are completely superimposed. It means if the one object is placed over other object, both the surface are completely captured and overlap on each other. And you see, and their corresponding sides are coinciding. And you see the both object looking like one object, appears as one object. Okay, understand? And it's also discussed in a bundle of 500 rupee notes. Okay, how all the notes are the same shape and the same size. Yes or no? The pages of your math book are also give the idea of the congruence, because every pages in your math book or your have the same shape and same size. What are the, yes or no? Yes. Okay, so each page is rectangular in shape and their corresponding length and width dimensions are equal. Understand? So all the pages in your math book are congruent. Similarly, here I am discussing about the congruent of triangles. What do you mean by congruent of triangles? Understand or not? Reeling is here, two triangular pieces I am holding here. Yes? Is it clear? So these two triangles are said to be congruent if their corresponding sides are equal. You see. And if two triangular figures are placed on each other, you will see their corresponding parts are completely superimposed. Look at here. Coinciding. Their corresponding sides are coinciding. Let us write the definition of congruence of triangle. So two triangles, first point I am talking, the two triangles, in two triangles, if three sides of one triangle are respectively equal, to the corresponding side sides of other triangle, then two triangles are said to be congruence, are said to be congruent. Yes or no? So always remember, if the corresponding sides, if the three sides of one triangle are respectively equal to the corresponding sides of other triangle, it means that both the triangles, if are placed on each other, then their corresponding sides are coincide. Yes or no? Look at here. You see, if I will show you, and this is another triangular face. If one place is kept over other surface, you see here, is it coinciding? This is triangular shape is what? This is also triangular shape, this is also triangular shape. But you see, the size of this triangular piece is bigger than this. So their corresponding sides are not same. Their corresponding sides are not same. It means both the triangular pieces are not superimposed and not overlap on each other. Right? Understand or not? Okay. So here we can say these two triangles cannot be congruent. Cannot be congruent. But this triangle we can say can be congruent. This triangle can be congruent, you can say. Yes or no? Yes, you see. Okay. Because we're putting these two triangular pieces on each other, their corresponding part completely superimposed. Okay. And their corresponding side coincide. This is one of the most important aspect of the congruence triangles. So if the two triangles are said to be congruent, if their corresponding sides are equal, or if the three sides of one triangle, okay, are respectively equal to the corresponding sides of other, then the triangle are congruent. Is it clear? Understand? Let's draw a diagram here. Here I am doing two triangles here. Triangle ABC. And triangle DA. Look at here. So in the triangle ABC and DF, suppose AB is equal to 6 cm. And D is also 6 cm, let us strike a triangle. Similarly, B is equal to 8.5 cm and EF is equal to 8.5 cm. Okay, and this is 9 cm and this length is also 9 cm. And looking here in the triangle ABC and DEF, in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, look at here, point 1. You see the AB side is equal to DE side. Yes or no? AB side is equal to DE side, which is 6 cm. And this is called the corresponding side. The corresponding side of AB is DE. This is one of the most vital concept of the congruency. And what is corresponding parts? What are the corresponding parts and what are the corresponding sides and corresponding angles? Or any corresponding part of two congruent object. That's very important to know. Second point is that BC side, you see, the BC is equal to what? 8.5 cm and EF is also 8.5 cm. So BC is equal to EF, which 8.5 cm. So the corresponding part of BC is EF. Okay. Third point, understand, AC is equal to almost 9 cm and DF is also 9 cm. You see now, AC is equal to DF, 9 cm. So you see now, in these triangles, two triangle ABC and DEF, okay, understand? So three sides of this triangle are respectively equal to the corresponding sides of the triangle DEF. So we can say these two triangle ABC and DEF are said to be congruent. Okay, and if both the triangles will placed over each other and they will be, their corresponding part will coincide. It means both the surface will overlap on each other. Understand or not? Okay. And this is about the idea about the congruency of triangle. Understand or not? Okay. Is it clear? Okay. Let's see. Note down. Okay. Another thing is that one of the vital part of the properties of the congruence triangles. Remember, see, if the two triangles, one of the properties, let us point one of the important notes I am writing, note one. Yes, if the two triangles are congruent, if the two triangles are congruent, suppose you see the triangle is, look at here, now you see ABC and DEF. If the two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding sides are always equal and their corresponding angles are also always equal. Remember, okay, not one, if triangle, okay, and if two triangles are congruent, if two triangles are congruent, one important points, then their corresponding sides are equal. Okay, understand? And their corresponding angles are also equal. And their corresponding angles are equal. Understand or not? So you see the triangle ABC. Now triangle ABC and triangle congruent. The triangle what? DEF. Okay. This triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF. Then what are the corresponding side? Number one. Corresponding sides. First important point, the corresponding sides. What are the corresponding sides? Okay. You see now without looking figure also you can understand. Okay, right? Triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF. Okay, look at there. Here the first vertex. Okay, A. Here first vertex is D. It means the corresponding vertex of the triangle ABC of A is D. Similarly, the corresponding vertex of B is E. And the corresponding vertex of C is F. In a similar order, in the similar manner, and you will find out the corresponding parts. Okay. Understand? Let us write corresponding vertex first. Corresponding vertexes. So what are the corresponding vertexes? The corresponding vertex of A is what? Is D. The corresponding vertex of B is what? Can you tell B is what? E. Is it clear? And the corresponding vertex of C is what? F. C is F. These are the corresponding vertex. Corresponding vertex of A is D. And the corresponding vertex of B is E. And then corresponding vertex of C is F. Understand? So, okay? Understand? This is about the corresponding vertex. Okay. Then, corresponding sides you write. Corresponding. Second point you write. Corresponding sides. And these are called the corresponding part of congruence triangle. In short, CPCT. Corresponding part of congruence triangle. Corresponding sides. You see AB. If you vertex A and B, suppose I will take A and B. AB is the, look at here. AB. Suppose I am taking the side AB. In this manner, start from A to B. Look at my finger point. In a similar manner, the corresponding side of A to B is D to E. D to E. Is it clear? Without looking at the figure, if this part is written, this triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF, so AB, corresponding part of AB is DE, right? So, here you see AB is equal to DE, right? Understand? Okay, this is one of the, similarly, second point, suppose I will take BC is another side, BC, look at here, BC of the triangle ABC. So what is the corresponding part of the triangle BC is what? It will be, look at here, BC and it will be EF, yes, it will be EF, yes or no? Understand? Okay. Third point, if I will take another side is AC. AC, look at here, AC, first vertex and last vertex. Similarly, its corresponding part will be the first vertex and last vertex. Here the first vertex what? D and the last vertex what? F, last vertex F, so DF. So this is called the corresponding sides, or we can say the corresponding part of congruent triangles. Understood or not? Okay. Or you say in simply what we say? CPCT. Okay. Is it clear? So very vital whenever you are finding the triangle congruency, what are their corresponding sides, what are their corresponding vertices. Let us see what are their corresponding angles. Okay, is it okay? Note down corresponding, the next point, corresponding angles. Corresponding angles, third point, corresponding angle. Corresponding angle. Okay, yes. So now let us see in the triangle ABC. Suppose I am taking the angle A. Suppose I am taking the angle A angle. A angle means which angle I can say? I can say A angle or B A C angle. Look at point. B A C angle. Similarly, B A C angle means or A angle. Same, in the same manner, in the same order, if I will tell the corresponding angle will be EDF angle. Yes or no? BAC is equal to EDF. Are you looking here? Yes, EDF. Okay, look at here BAC. You see BAC angle means which angle? A angle. Similarly, EDF angle means which angle? This is X, if X degree, this also X degree will be there. Understand or not? This is first point. Again, another angles, I can say B angle. B angle means what? I can say also A, B, C angle. Can I say A, B, C angle is equal to A, B, C angle in a similar manner? How can I say? Yes, D, E, F angle. Yes or no? Yes, D, E, F angle. Yes, this is called CPCT, corresponding part of congruence triangle. Okay, this is the second point. So third angle is the C angle. We look at here ABC angle. ABC angle means which angle you see? This is the B angle. This, suppose this is Y degree, and ABC angle into DEF angle. This value also Y degree. Yes or no? Okay. Is it clear? And third point is that C angle. C angle means, look at here, ACB angle. ACB angle is equal to ACB in the same manner is DFE. Can I say ACB angle is equal to DFE angle? DFE angle is. So this is called CPCT. CPCT are the corresponding parts of congruence triangle. Very important. Okay. Understand? So corresponding vertex, corresponding sides, and corresponding angles. Okay. How to identify? And it is the okay. And you can see also ACB angle C. ACB angle is which angle? C angle, yes or no? Suppose this angle is Z degree. So this angle also ACB angle is equal to DFE angle. Yes, this is also Z degree. Look at here, ACB and DFE. Is it clear, students? Okay, understand? So this is how you will find out the what do you mean by the corresponding part of congruence triangle. Understand or not? Another point I want to tell you. I said if the three sides of two triangles are same, equal, then three sides, three corresponding sides of two triangles are equal, then they are congruent. But converse is not true. Suppose if you will take the two triangles, their three angles, their three corresponding angles are equal, the triangles are not congruent. So angle condition does not satisfy the congruence of triangle, one of the important point. Okay, I like to say. But side condition is always satisfy the congruence of triangle. Okay. Understand? Is it clear? Okay, this is about the idea about the congruence of triangle, and in the next class we shall discuss about the criteria of the congruence of triangles. What are the necessary condition, and what are the different criterion? What are the different criteria of the congruence of triangle? We shall discuss in the next class. Till then, thank you. Okay, so let us note down this, and also practice. Thank you.